Good morning. Today we are going to see some bullet points. Here there is no objective problems, there is no numerical problems, only bullet points in the atomic structure. Okay, there are some atom models, in that I have given some bullet points so that you can easily answer objective questions in that topic. Okay, first one is Thomson's atom model. In Thomson atom model, already we have seen the first point is every atom consists of a positively charged sphere of radius of the order of 10 into 10 power meter, 10 into 10 power minus 10 meter. Okay, that means it is a very simple concept only. They may ask, what is the order of the, okay, or radius of the Thomson's atom model's atom, just like, okay, because basically they have given this. Therefore, for very minor questions, they can answer and ask like this, okay. This is radius of the atom of Thomson's atom model, okay. And what are the limitations of Thomson atom model? The first one is, it could not explain the origin of spectral lines of hydrogen and other atoms. Already I explained in the class, what is meant by spectral lines, okay. Actually, this atom model should explain what is the reason for the spectral lines when light is passing through some specimen, for example, hydrogen or other atoms, then there is a splitting up of lines. Then what is the reason for that? It should explain, but this atom model couldn't explain. Therefore, it is one of the limitation. And second one is, it couldn't explain Rutherford large scattering. Okay, already we have seen when alpha ray is sent, then it is deflected. Okay, then why it is deflecting? What is the reason for large angle scattering of alpha particle? It couldn't explain. Okay, that means it could not explain large angle scattering of alpha particles in Rutherford experiment. These are all the two limitations of Thomson's atom model. The next one is regarding Rutherford alpha ray experiment. Okay, I have given some bullet points only. Thin gold foil is used, and whose thickness is of the order of 2.1 into 10 power minus 7 meter, okay. And in that, we are using one detector. That detector screen is coated with zinc sulfide. The detector is coated with zinc sulfide. When radiation falls on zinc sulfide, then scintillations are observed. Okay, that means bright flashes are observed. For that only, for that purpose, we have coated, not we, Rutherford coated, okay, zinc sulfide on the screen of the detector. Okay, then an alpha particle is over 7000 times more massive than an electron. Okay, they may ask this type of simple questions. Okay, then the tiny central core of each atom is called atomic nucleus. Okay, I already told you, Rutherford is the first scientist to name the positive structure of the atom as nucleus. Okay, and it is well concentrated at the center. Therefore, tiny central core is called nucleus. Okay, and which is positive. The next one, the scattering is due to elastic collision between nucleus and alpha particle. They may ask whether it is a elastic collision or inelastic collision. Okay, it is a elastic collision between nucleus. That means this is also positive and this is also positive. Okay, therefore repulsion takes place, and the type of scattering is elastic scattering. Here there is no physical touch in this scattering. Without touching, okay, the scattering occurs. Next one, at R naught, what is R naught? R naught is the distance of closest approach. The alpha particle retraces its path, turning through 180 degree. I explained in the class, when alpha particle is coming from this point, okay, and in this direction, and this is the gold foil, and he explained here it is considering as a nucleus, okay. Therefore, when alpha particle is coming in this direction, now after reaching one particular point, due to repulsion, it is retracing, it is making a head-on collision, and it is retracing its original path. Therefore, it turns, it take a U-turn, okay. Then it is coming in the same direction, okay. That means opposite direction in the same this point, okay, to this point. Therefore, the angle is 180 degree, okay. They may ask like this. Now, this is the distance of closest approach, just like I told in the class, okay. One magnet is there, north pole, and another magnet is there, okay. You cannot touch these two, north pole, okay. They will repel. Just like alpha particle is a positive and nucleus is positive, both are repelling. They will maintain some minimum distance. That distance is called distance of closest approach, okay. The next one, at this point, that means at or not, that means at this point, okay. At this point, the entire kinetic energy of the alpha particle is converted into electric potential energy. That means alpha particle is coming with kinetic energy, and it is stopped by the nucleus. Therefore, the entire kinetic energy is converted into potential energy. After that, it is going back. Okay. The next one, R0 is calculated as 30 Fermi. Okay. That means in the original experiment, they have calculated R0 by substituting many values. Okay. And it is equal to 30 Fermi. 1 Fermi equal to what? 10 power minus 15 meter. Therefore, they may ask in this also, or they can ask this also. Okay, that means Fermi is a scientist name given in order to honor him. Okay. Next one, when the impact parameter B is small, alpha particles will be deflected more. I explained what is meant by impact parameter. That means assume this is a nucleus, positive charge, okay, that means a nucleus, okay, and we assumed phi alpha particle, and this is making a head-on collision, and it is retracing its path, and this alpha particle, okay, is coming in this direction. Now, the distance between this line and this distance, that means vertical distance, is called impact factor or impact parameter B, okay. Now, they are giving pointers or relating the deflection and this impact parameter. What happened to deflection when this distance increases or decreases? Okay, that is when impact parameter is small, that means when B is small, when B equal to small, the deflection is more because it will be deflected more. Therefore, this angle is deflection angle, it is more. Now, the impact parameter is more. That means here if you take it is 1 centimeter, and if you take this is 5 centimeter, then it will be deflected less. Okay. That means B is large, it is 5 centimeter I am telling. Okay, it is 1 centimeter for example, actually it is not centimeter. Okay. Now, it will be deflected very less. When it is increased to 10, then there will not be deflection at all. Okay. Now, the next one, size of the nucleus according to Rutherford is 10 power minus 15 meter. Already we have seen size of the atom. Now, this is size of the nucleus. You should remember this. You should not confused. Okay. We have seen in the first question size of the or radius of the atom. Now, this is the nucleus. Then what are the limitations of Rutherford? When electrons are revolving, there will be loss of energy. So electron will finally fall into the nucleus. Then atom will not be stable. Okay. Actually, Rutherford told nucleus is the center, R positive charge is there, and we name it as a nucleus, and electrons are revolving in a circular orbit. Electrons are revolving in a circular orbit according to his theory. Okay. But if electrons are revolving means any charged particle, when it is moving, it will emit electromagnetic radiation or electric energy as well as magnetic energy. That means electric field and magnetic will be produced. When the radiation is there, then automatically there will be a loss of energy. When there is a loss of energy, automatically it will be attracted by this nucleus. Then it will spiral like this, and finally it will fall into the nucleus. Then there is a question of stability. Okay, therefore the electron cannot revolve just like he told. Okay, therefore it is a limitation of Rutherford. The next one, Bohr atom model. Okay, now some bullet points I have given. Atom can revolve only in certain stable orbits with a fixed energy level. According to Rutherford, Rutherford didn't mention any orbit position. He just told electrons are revolving in circular orbit. Therefore, there was a question about the stability. A moving electron radiates energy. Due to the radiation, it will fall on the nucleus. Okay. Therefore, he modified this drawback. Who modified? Bohr modified. Okay. Instead of telling any orbit, he fixed some orbit. That means atom can revolve only in certain stable orbits with fixed energy levels. Atom, electron cannot revolve in any of the orbit. There are some fixed stationary orbits. That is his first postulate. Okay. And the second one is, angular momentum of the revolving electron is an integral multiple of h by 2 pi. That means electron cannot revolve in any of the orbit, and its angular momentum is integral multiple of h by 2 pi, where h is the Planck's constant and n is the integral number, 1, 2, 3, just like. Okay. And this is mv is the linear momentum. When you multiply with r, then it is angular momentum. Therefore, angular momentum of the electron is equal to nh by 2 pi. This is the second postulate of Bohr. The next one is, it is a bullet point, radii of stationary orbits are in the ratio. Okay. That means nucleus is there, and first orbit, second orbit, third orbit. Okay. First, second, third. They are in the ratio, this is 1 square, 2 square, 3 square, just like. That means the space between them is not equal. Okay, the first space, the first orbit radius is 1 square. The second orbit radius is 2 square, that means 4. And the third orbit is 9. That means in between the space is not equal. The next one is, the total energy of electron is negative. It means electron is bound to the nucleus and is not free to leave it. Okay. The electron is always bound to the nucleus. That means force of attraction is there, because nucleus is positive and electron is negative. Therefore, this electron cannot leave easily. And if you want to take one electron, means you can take the outermost electron. Okay, by giving some suitable energy, you can remove this outermost electron only, and you cannot remove innermost electrons. Okay, and energy in the outer orbit is more than that of inner orbit. Okay, energy of the outer orbit is more. That means you can simply give little energy and you can remove this. That is the concept. And I told it is a minus. That means it is more minus, it is more minus, means more minus means less amount of energy you can give. The next one, the value of conductivity for semiconductor lies between, okay, that means the conductivity of the semiconductor lies between 10 power minus 5 to 10, or resistivity, okay, it is 10 power 5 to 10 ohm meter, okay, the resistivity of the semiconductor is 10 power 5 to 10 ohm meter. The next one, the minimum energy required for shifting electrons from valence band to conduction band is called energy gap. Okay, that means in semiconductor this question is coming, that means in a conduction band, valence band we can draw, okay, this is a valence band, this is a conduction band, in between the gap is called energy band gap. The minimum energy required for shifting electrons from valence band conduction band is called energy band gap. Okay, now if you want to transfer one electron from here to here, means that energy is called energy band gap. Now energy band gap for different material is different, it is not same for all the materials, it is different for different materials. For conductor metals it is different, for insulator it is different, and for semiconductor it is different. Okay, and the last question is, semiconductor at 0 Kelvin behaves as insulator. Okay, what's meant by 0 Kelvin? I hope you understand. Okay, this is very simple question. Semiconductor at absolute 0, okay, that is 0 Kelvin, behaves as insulator. Okay, just like some bullet points I will give you in some other class also. Therefore, you should read the topics and you should remember these bullet points. Thank you.